Because of coronavirus, TJ Shuck is 3 weeks behind on his rent.
I've got a one-year-old and a three-year-old. I'm finally getting more hours. I can pay the rent. It's just going to take me a second.
But TJ's landlord is not waiting. Despite a statewide moratorium on evictions, she's filed a lawsuit to evict TJ and his family from their apartment.
I have a court date on the 18th of next month.
Well, the response from 13 News viewers was overwhelming. We got dozens of emails from people who saw the story and want to make sure TJ and his family can stay here in this apartment.
It's amazing. Thank you very much. Very much appreciated. There's a lot of people out there that need a lot of help.
A church is paying TJ's overdue rent, and another family has paid next month's rent. And because TJ is a veteran, there are other programs to help people in his situation.
The need is greater than we've ever seen at any time in history that we know of.
The Indiana Department of Veterans Affairs wants Hoosier veterans to know about the state's Military Family Relief Fund. It now has a special program to help veterans financially impacted by the coronavirus.
We can offer the fund to veterans who are in need and can't pay their bills.
We've been told that we're safe. We've been told not to worry about losing our homes.
Jonathan Faust is looking for other sources of support. He got an eviction letter from the same landlord that is trying to evict TJ. But Jonathan is not a veteran. He's a single dad working two jobs until the pandemic hit. Now he's 3 weeks behind on rent, and he doesn't understand how landlords are still filing evictions.
Regardless of what our president or our governor is saying, we have these people that are still trying to get money from us, that are still trying to get us pushed out of our homes.
People are not supposed to be filing eviction proceedings right now.
The Attorney General's office tells 13 Investigates landlords who do try to evict their tenants during the pandemic could face stiff penalties for violating the governor's order.
Those penalties can be up to $5,000 per violation. I would encourage anyone to follow the law and follow what the governor is asking us all to do.
If you are at risk of eviction and need help, or if you want to help someone who's at risk of eviction, we've got resources at WTHR.com.